What's up, Dragon Nation? I'm Rich with Dragon Nation Gaming. Welcome to another Space Engineers tutorial. This episode we'll be going over ships. Basically, the first ship that you ever want to build, if you haven't built yourself a respawn ship, is a miner. So that way you can get more resources and you get to a point where you can start building bigger. Well, there's a few things that we have to go over, so let's go ahead and get this started. So back in the day, there used to be only one way of actually starting a ship. You would go into the G menu, and I think it was down here on the right side of the screen. It was a selection that you could make between a small grid ship, a large grid ship, or a station. If you started with a small grid ship or a large grid ship, it would start you with the landing gear. If you were building a base, it would start you with an armor block. That was a long time ago. Now there's multiple different ways you could start a new base or a new ship. Let me see if I can find. So you can't do it the old way. You could go ahead and get yourself a landing gear and rotate it. Oh, it didn't set it up instantly. That sucks. Try to rotate it so that way you can get the landing gear to lock on the armor block. And nope, that's not it. This is the part that could be a pain in the ass. Now there are better ways of doing it. Ways are a lot easier. Let's try that. There it goes. So when you do build them, even if you're not building in creative, you're building in survival, it still will automatically lock to your station. Now there's a problem with this. One, this is not connected to anything, so there is no power getting to your ship. If you have a ship that you want to run with batteries, you won't have a way of charging it up. So it would need its own power source. But now there is a better way of doing it. So if you already had your base set up like our starter base we did in another previous episode, just go ahead, put down a rotor, get rid of the small or large grid head, the original head, go to a control panel, go to the rotor, and add small head. Now, we can actually connect a small drill ship to that rotor, and since it is a subgrid of the station, it will get power to charge batteries if you're using a ship that requires battery power. Now, one of the things that happens in Space Engineers is in the beginning, when you first start playing the game, you're going to be building bricks, is what we call them. Basically, what we mean by that is you haven't really learned how the different blocks in the game work yet. So you'll go through a lot of trial and error trying to get you a ship that works properly. Then also trying to make it look decent, you'll build, well, a brick, and that's why we call it that. But there's a few things you need to know when you're building your own ship. The main things that you are going to need, let me go in and build out a platform so I can show you. If we build out a platform, in order to build a ship, we're going to need thrusters. It's probably the most important part of a ship, but it isn't the only thing that's really important. So if we go ahead and put a thruster going forward, we need to make sure that we have a thruster pointing in every direction when we are in space. So of course, forward, backwards, left. Let me put one right here so we can try to make something symmetrical a little bit. And right. Then we also need one for up, and then another one for down. So now that we have thrusters in every direction, the next thing that we're going to need is, well, a gyroscope. You cannot turn your ship without a gyroscope. But keep in mind, this is one thing that we all forget. Anybody who's played this game for any length of time has always forgotten a gyroscope at one point or another. The next thing you need to worry about is power, and I kind of built myself into a corner here. So we talked about power a couple episodes ago. There's a number of different ways that we can get power to the ship. One I'm going to go ahead and do is battery power. So if this is this ship you decide to make battery power, it is connected to the station, so that battery will be able to charge until you get the ship finished. So the next thing you need to worry about when you're building a ship, this thing is going to be ugly, is you need a way to control it. You need a seat or a cockpit. So if we take a look at cockpits, you'll notice that we have a few different options. Now, a couple of these are DLC. This one, the buggy cockpit, is from one of the DLCs. And the industrial cockpit, is another DLC. If you don't want to spend the money on the DLCs, the cockpits that you'll have is this cockpit, the fighter cockpit, and a rover cockpit. There are also, if I can find them, in seat. You have flight seats, which I don't think are for, no, they're not for small grid. They're only for large grid. Control seat, which is for large and small grid. And, well, toilet. I guess if you wanted to, you could control it with the toilet seat, but you would need a remote control block for that one. And then a passenger seat, which is just like the toilet. It doesn't have controls, but you can control the ship if you have a remote on it. So the other ones are the cockpits. I can't really remember. Yeah, this one right here apparently is for large grid. Is it? Nah. Yeah, it is. I thought that was a mod, but no, it's for large and small grid. Well, it's been a while since I've done nothing but vanilla, so that was new to me. Industrial cockpit is also small and large grid. You can tell by this over here, over on the top right-hand corner. Fighter cockpit is only for small grid. The rover cockpit is only for small grid, and the buggy cockpit is only for small grid. We're going to go ahead and go with the regular cockpit, which was the original. We're just going to go ahead and put it right on front. And right now, you have yourself a ship. It is that simple. Just make sure you have enough thrusters, you have a gyroscope, power, and then a way of controlling it. Now all we got to do is disconnect it. So I got to make sure I don't disconnect it in the wrong spot. Everything's still connected. I think we're good. Yep, it's not falling apart, so I think we're good. All right, let's go on and get into the seat and see just how well the ship works. I call it a ship, but that's very iffy. All right, so it moves forward, backwards, right, left, up, and C is down. And then, of course, now that we have a gyro on it, we could also turn left, right, up, down. Like I said, without a gyroscope, I wouldn't be able to move it like that. So if all I was talking about was how to make a working ship, this would be the end of the video. But ships can have multiple purposes. So we have ourselves, do I have blocks for block tools? This one right here. So we can add drills to make this a mining ship. We could add grinders to make it a grinding ship. Or we could add welders to make it a welding ship. This episode, we're going to go ahead and talk about drill ships, miners. So I'm going to go ahead and put a drill on either side. So right here, this would be enough to get your first drill ship. Now, it doesn't hold a whole lot of inventory. So if you go out, grab some resources, all you will have is what's in the drill for inventory, which is 33,000 liters, 33,750 liters. In each one of those drills. But like I said, you would have to go out, fill up that drill, come back, go back out to get enough ore. So the first thing you want to figure out is how much ore do you want to go out and get. The more trips you make, the longer it's going to take you to get enough ore. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up something real quick with enough inventory space to show you what I usually do. Alright, so if we take a look real quick, what I did was I filled this cargo container up with 100,000 of each ore. Now, that is specific to the way that I like to play. It used to be 100,000 of each ore was enough to get me to the point where I have a large grid miner and a heavy production facility. But the game has changed a lot over time, so this might be something I have to rethink. But 100,000 of each ore would be the next tier of production for me, because this is how I play. Now, of course, you could do this any way you want. You could raise this to like 250,000 if you wanted to. If you really wanted to, you can make it a million, but I'd wait for that amount of ore until you have a large grid miner. It'd make it a whole lot easier. This is just to get me enough ore to get me to the next stage where I have a large grid miner, and then I could get tons and tons of ore. But like I said, since the game has changed over time, I won't get as much out of this ore as I would have before, like years ago. So I might have to actually have to go out a couple more trips just to get enough, especially with iron, because iron is used for just about everything. So like I said, this is to save time. What I do is I take my miner out once I build it, go out one time, just one time, fill it up with ore, make sure I have about 100,000 of each ore, and then I'm done. I don't have to take my miner out again unless I start to run out of something, but usually it's just iron, maybe gold sometimes, and that's about it. So what I need to do is I need to figure out how much cargo space I need to put on that ship, or inventory space I need to put on that ship, to reach 407,000 kilograms. That's how much 100,000 of each ore will fill up my ship. So I already know exactly how much that is going to be. Alright, so as I said, 407,000 kilograms is how much, or no, 407,000 liters, my bad. 407,000 liters is how much I need to hold in inventory, and this is what I need to hold that amount. One large cargo container, one small grid large cargo container is 156,250 liters. The medium cargo container is 33,750. Now, the drills themselves also handle inventory space. Each one handles about 33,750, which I think was the same amount as, yep, the medium cargo container. So if we take the amount of drills that we have, and also the medium cargo container, because it's the same amount, we have 8 drills plus the medium cargo container. So that's 9 items. So 33,750 liters times 9 plus 156,250 liters. Now, I already did the math. I know exactly how much that is. That is 460,000 liters. We only need 407,000. So we're good. But that's okay, because eventually I'll go out mining. When I do go out mining, maybe I'll accidentally, I'm not paying attention, and I'll grab just a little bit more iron or some other ore than what I needed. So it's actually better to have a little bit more inventory space. Now, when it comes to building ships, as far as inventory, it's a little bit different when it comes to a small grid than it goes with a large grid. And that is the access points. Each one of these blocks has its own, I guess, assortment of access points. Small grid blocks actually have large access points and small access points. Now, the reason for this is a lot of people got upset that you're able to pass stuff through small access points that they didn't think you should, because of the size of them. So what they did was they made it possible for ore and ingots to pass through small access points, and components can only pass through large access points. What I need to do is I need to design a ship that could hold all these. So 8 drills, medium cargo container, and a large cargo container. But before we go into that, I want to kind of do a little bit to help out those new players that are kind of worried about how their ships look. Alright, the game crashed on me again. This is getting old. But it's one of those things you have to deal with when you play Space Engineers. So what I would like to do right now is I would like to do a little something for the new players that are worried about how their ships look. so many times I hear in the comment section of videos or in the chat and live stream, people are so worried about their ships looking like bricks. But you shouldn't worry about that. You're a new player. Of course, your ship is going to look like a brick because, well, you don't have a whole lot of experience with the different blocks. So you're not really, you don't have the experience to place blocks so that way your ship is functional but still looks good. Your ships will evolve over time. What I want to do is I want to go ahead and show you the first ship that I ever built. Well, the first mining ship that I ever built in Space Engineers. And I present to you the pill. This was the first ship that I ever designed in Space Engineers. Well, no, it was the first. No, it was actually the first ship that I ever designed when I started playing Space Engineers. Because when I first started, I didn't play in creative. I started playing Space Engineers in survival. So I didn't worry about ship looks, the way a ship looks. I didn't worry about the design. I just worried about making it practical, something that you could use and did its job well. And I've carried that on up until this time. I'm not really one of those people who will build big capital ships. I don't really like building them. I stick to just little ships like this that get the job done. Now, this ship I designed before we had batteries, before we had oxygen, pretty much in the early days. I think Survival had just been out for about a month, somewhere around there. Survival had just come out not too long ago, and this is what I got. So not a whole lot on it. There's nothing for oxygen. There is the only power we have right now is reactor. That was available at the time. So this thing has a lot more power than it actually needs. What I would like to do is I'd like to go ahead and get rid of the armor blocks right now so I could go ahead and show you the mechanicals of this ship. All right, so I think I got rid of everything. Well, at least the armor blocks. One thing I forgot about was the front thrusters are no longer connected to the ship because they were actually connected to the blocks that were sitting right behind it. But at least this will give you an idea of the mechanics that went into this ship. So basically all it was a cockpit with conveyors behind it so it can connect to that cargo container, also to have the cockpit connected for whatever reason. I just decided it was better to do that, make sure everything was connected. Then the medium cargo container was connected to the reactor. And then of course the conveyors that come out from behind the cockpit are connected to the drills. And that's it. Just add thrusters. And then of course I needed to put a detector in, which I put right there. It's hidden by the armor blocks when this thing is finished. On the other side we have the antenna. And I think this was also the first ship that I experimented with the remote control block. I can't remember, but I think this is when the remote control block came out. So yeah, I think remote control and cameras had just come out. So I wanted to experiment with it. So on this ship, I went ahead and added remote control block, the antenna, so that way we control it, can control it, and then also the cameras, so that way I can see where the hell I'm going. So two cameras, one in the front, one in the bottom, so that way I can connect. And that was it. That was the first ship. Then the next update we got into the game were batteries. So I kind of figured out that, yeah, that reactor is way too much power for the ship. Oh, are those thrusters not connected either? No, they're not. Oh, well. So I kind of figured out that it was a little too much power. So I went ahead and decided I was going to make this a rechargeable ship. I was going to go ahead and add some batteries to it. So let me go ahead and do that real quick. So I replaced the batteries or the reactor with batteries, but then I realized that the batteries are a little bit thicker. So I had to extend the length of the entire ship one block. But the evolution of this ship does not stop there. In another update, we got ejectors into the game. Were they already in? I'm not sure, because that one I wasn't too sure about. I was still kind of learning the game a little bit. So ejectors might have been in the entire time, but I can't really remember. But one thing I did realize was when I was going out mining, I was picking up a lot of stone, which means my cargo container was getting filled up with stone and I wasn't able to grab some of the other resources. So I had to figure out a way of getting rid of it. Oh, I remember what just came out. Sorters. That was when sorters first came out in the game. So I wanted to get rid of the stone, but we didn't really have a way of doing that. Then they came out with sorters, which meant now I had a way of ejecting all that stone. And this is what I came up with. So all I got is a conveyor going to the conveyor junctions that went to the cockpit, brought them all the way back, put in the conveyor sorter, and then just put ejectors out the back. Now the sorter will allow the stone to go through that sorter. It will not allow it to go back. But it also keeps other resources like iron from getting to those ejectors. Back in the day, though, we did not have the ability to use the sorters to pull items. That was something they added later on. So this was the point that I got to. Then another thing happened. They started tweaking mining and resources, how much you can collect, how much you get from, how many ingots you get from ore. They started messing with all kinds of stuff. So I realized I needed a little bit more cargo space. I also started to figure out how much resources I need in order to get to the next stage of production, which was this, the 100,000 of each ore. And for a time that worked. So what I needed to do was I needed to extend the ship or upgrade it to give me a little bit more storage space. The only thing that I'm missing to have enough is a large cargo container and 4 more drills. So this, the pill, turned into this. This is the DNG mole. This was the years of evolution from the pill to the current ship. And as you can see, it is the same ship. Now, of course, I did have to change the power source because, well, there's a couple things I put on this ship. So with the added weight, we needed more thrust to be able to move. So back here we would have 8 thrusters instead of the 6 that I had on the pill. Also twice as many thrusters going in every direction. Well, no, it's still 4. Because I had 4 going left, right, up and down on that ship, and I still have 4 going left, right, up and down on this ship. I just have 8 going backwards and 8 going forward. But as you can see, one more cargo container, that large cargo container. We still have the medium cargo container, the power right behind it, and the ejectors in the back. Now, because of the added size of the cargo container, I was able to add more ejectors to get rid of that stone faster. Then, of course, we have 4 more drills on the front than just the 4 over here. We now have 8. The cockpit's still the same with the lights and the camera. Cockpit with the lights and the camera. And then, of course, connector, which the connector is missing right there, but it would be right there. The connector and the camera down at the bottom. So pretty much the exact same ship, just a little bit evolved. And then, of course, for mods, I go ahead and leave this space open for jump drive whenever I use the mod Small Ship Mega Mod Packs, which allows you to put a jump drive on a small grid. So yeah, that's the evolution of my drill ship. From just a small little thing with a medium cargo container and a few drills, over to this beast, which works perfectly. I love this ship. Even in vanilla, if I use all vanilla thrusters and everything, it still works pretty good. And I haven't really found a reason to evolve it even further. As far as I'm concerned right now, as a small ship miner goes, this is the perfect ship. But just keep that in mind when you're trying to design your first miner. Your first ship is not going to look all that great. It probably will look like a piece of shit, which is okay. That's fine. There is nothing wrong with your ship looking like a piece of shit. As long as it works, that's all that matters. What does matter is what you do with the ship over time. Now, in Space Engineers is one of those games where you will put hours and hours into. So as long as you're using whatever creative imagination you get after you get some experience in the game and start learning the blocks a little bit better, you'll be able to build, well, better ships. But I hope that'll help you out, and it kind of puts some things at ease about you not feeling great about your own designs. Don't feel bad. We all started out building bricks. We all did. Don't let anybody tell you different. So the next thing we need to go into, we are ready for the next tier of production, which means a larger base and a larger mining ship to get even more ore. But yeah, we'll talk about that in the next episode. Until then, make sure to like and subscribe, all that good stuff. I'll see you on the next one. Peace.